Nismo baš najljepše vrijeme naručili za trčanje. Prvi dan u Bostonu.
Nismo,
ali... Jak, vjetar i kiš.
Berkeley Street. Mislim da nam je ovdje backdrop na Berkeley and Boston.
Idemo na rutu. Bosto znaju.
Bliz smo cilje.
Bliz smo cilje, a tek prešli 300 metara.
Tako, bravo ga.
Boston Common Park.
Ovama će biti autobus.
Autobuse za ukrcavanje maratonaca pred put u Hopkinton na start.
Evo
banera, reći ljuče. Baner je spočito,
Komonska bara.
Jezero. Reci to u kameru.
Dobro, pa danas nije trka, nije ni povoljen vjetara, ni kiša.
Ja, vjetar baš.
Nadamo se dobro vreme.
A kiša normalna, nije jako ništa ekstra. Da, temperatura nije ona niska puno. Feels like je 10, a 16 je temperatura. Evo, postavljaju se WC-ovi za Boston Common Park, odnosno da, prije polaska, na, prije polaska u Hopkinton, tegače.
Renty 7th Mile Portrait Party. Tu ćemo doći kršeni da pojedemo, popijemo šta god.
Tako je. Da uče
poznamo. Ja, da se upoznamo.
Wilson Street. A treba smo na kretan,
jer smo od idemo po brojeve. Level 1. Joj, bib number, race, take t-shirt pickup.
Ovdje zagužba, ako bude regionalno, onda bude sve, kad je gužba.
Pa nije još počeo pick-up, pa zato nije, je gužo.
Pa nije počeo, zato su ljudi rede. Lagano.
Ima red od kilometar. To je zato što smo došli ranije.
Pa bolje.
Dijeli se besplatna hrana.
Evo, pa to sam.
Nema kraja redu za podizanje tačnih brojeva.
Thank you. Good morning. Good morning.
Moraš imati volontera koji govori stalno good morning. Evo i plava linija. U Boylston ulici. Edina diže broj.
Ovo
Okret prema cilju i zadnjih oko 900 do 1000 metara. Zagužvalo na Expu.
Mi smo na vrijeme, tačno. Bez redova velikih, bez čekanja.
Evo, cilj postavljen. 3 dana prije. Saobraćaj zatvoren. Keeping your life in motion. Evo YouTuberi rokaju. Hey guys! Evo Kofuzi! Kofuzi, ozbiljno. Just to post. Evo, viš da nosi onu kameru, Instagram. Ovaj dik legenda dominira, vidiš. Će gorit poslije trku. Evo svi.
Or the rain.
cirka Boston 5K, subota 8 sati.
My top 23 favorite countries in North America. There's only 23, but it's up there. It's wicked north. It's way, way north. Is anybody on board from Massachusetts? No? Okay, good. No fact checkers. Believe what I... He brought the Puritans here from Boston, England. Now, there were already settlers here back then. This was known as Shawmut Peninsula. Here's an old map. This is what it used to look like. Shawmut Peninsula was just a mile and a half of land, surrounded on three sides by water. And the small group of settlers came here from a place called Lincolnshire. Ben Affleck and Matt Damon are in it. They wrote the script together. This is like before they were famous, and they ended up winning the Academy Award for Best Original Screenplay. So they filmed some pivotal scenes over here. They also filmed some in the Boston Public Garden. Kind of the odd thing about that movie, though, a lot of that movie was filmed in Canada, because back then, in the late 90s, it was very expensive to film in Boston. Now it's pretty cheap, so you get a lot of movies that are made over here. I'll talk more about them later. But yeah, this is the commuter rail train tracks. We're going over on the left, big blue building on the right, that's the commuter rail garage. So if you want to make a day trip up to Salem, the commuter rail is probably your best bet. To get up there, you get there in like a half an hour. Driving can take about 15 minutes. That's a cool walkway. The walkway takes you from the skateboard park into a brand new park called Paul Revere Park, and then that's right across the street from City Square Park. So you can kind of take a shortcut over there if you're walking over from the aquarium. We're waiting for an orange duck to leave from the water, or as the French call it, duck la orange. So this is exciting. If you want to take a video of us splashing in, get your camcorders ready. Just make sure you remove the lens cap, put the tape in, make sure it's rewound, and if the record tab is broken, just put a piece of tape over it. And then when we honk the horn, you hit play and record at the same time. And we're gonna quack too. I'll say stay busy. You guys say quack quack. That's how I normally do it, but I forgot. If anybody asks, I'll say stay busy, you say quack quack. It's gonna be exciting. Alright. Okay. Oh, this one's got an endorsement for Saran Wrap. Alright. Ready? Okay. That's Luis and Harvey. That's Harvey. That's his real name. Hi, Luis. Hi, Harvey. Hey, I got some people running the marathon on board. Yeah. Yeah. They said they're gonna destroy you.
Yeah.
yeah.
Okay, sorry, it's just, it is. All right, listen, it's not a race. It's, wait, it is a race?
It is.
Okay, it's not, okay. We just want to have a good time. I gotta go. I got some, I'm in the middle of a tour. Quack, quack. Oh, yeah, quack, 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 quack.
Quack,
quack. He thinks he's so great. Okay, we're going down the ramp, so remember, seatbelts are unavailable to you, but I have one. Okay, you can have this. All right, just hold on. Charge! Welcome to the Charles River, everybody. We promised you land and water. We have now done both. So what we're gonna do next is turn around and leave. Now we're hanging out. Look at the left, it's a magic orb filled with friendly people. If you wave at them, they'll wave at you. It's just a mirror, but I'm easily amused. That yellow structure on the left, it's a train bridge. Call it a rolling bascule bridge. It also opens up for boats to go under it. So this is the lower base of the Charles River, where it ends. We're gonna see a bunch of birds. Those birds that are on top of the wood there, there's a bunch of them on the left sitting on the dock of the bay watching the tide roll away. Those are called double-crested cormorants. Those are fishy birds. They can dive 180 feet deep. It's not that deep here, but they also go in the ocean. They can eat three times their body weight in a fish per day, which is a lot of mercury. But double-crested cormorants also have twice as many crests as the average cormorant. You see that beautiful episode on it? I remember the night that the day that I watched it on the common room TV of the juvenile detention center. I was incarcerated. I'm kidding. I watched it alone. I was in solitary. Female. They have green and blue heads, and they refuse to pull over and ask for directions. They are Martha, I know how to fly south. Turn off the GPS. You're killing my data plan. That's my impression of a male dog. Man, Canada geese look. They're not as polite as Canadian people, so lunch, just keep. That's a word that means town that is new. Makes sense, right? So the first college opened out in 1636. It was called The College. Pretty spot on name. Then 2 years later, a man passed away, left half of his fortune and his entire library to the college. So they renamed it in his honor. That man's name was John Massachusetts Institute of Technology. That was John Harvard. That's where Harvard came up. If you kids want to go to Harvard, all you gotta do is start. Celia, sorry, it's hard for you to hear. I'm listening to a podcast. Alright. Celia, look at me. What a girl. One more time. That's cool. So how do you know Annabelle? You guys work together? She's your sister? She's your oldest sister? Do you have other sisters? Do you have any other sisters besides Annabelle? No, so she's your oldest sister. She's the oldest sister that you have. So you gotta start introducing her. This is Annabelle, she's my oldest sister. I am the youngest sister that she has. Okay, you don't wanna do that. Okay, look to the left, you see the gold dome, the State House. That's real gold leaf, it's very, very thin. It only weighs about 13 pounds, so it's worth about $300,000, or best offer. All right, now Celia, with your left hand, can you reach towards the window? See how there's a silver button under the zippers? Can you reach that? Yeah. All right, don't touch it. It's for emergencies only. I was just showing you where it was. Come on, take. All right, now, oh, we're gonna see a duck on the left. And this is kind of a cool duck. So this duck is called the Life is Good duck. Life is good, you know, like the t-shirt brand. These stickers say life is good with the little stick figure on it. Because they're local business with us. We're friends with them. And this year is both our 30-year anniversary. So it's kind of cool. So we'll wave. We'll yell quack, quack. And then we'll go on our merry way.
All right.
What we want. Ready, everybody? Stay busy.
What do you mean? What do you mean? We were ready. I told them about the stickers.
Okay. I don't know her. She must be new. She's very confident.
After a really good thing that happened here, Chicago went a different way. Ours is called the New England Revolution. Theirs is called the Chicago Fire. Come on, Levi. It's too negative.
Exactly. Now, this area to your left, this is, well, I mean, you guys have the Los Angeles earthquakes or something. No, you have the galaxy. No, the San Jose earthquakes. I don't know what part of California you live in. Let me see some ID. Okay. Yeah, you got two teams. You got LAFC and the Galaxy. Oh, no. All right, over to the left, that's it's the latest example of landfill in Boston. It's called North Point Park. It was created as a result of digging up the two deepest tunnels in North America, part of the Central Artery Tunnel Project, which is the largest public works project in world history, but better known by a nickname. Anybody know the nickname? That's right, the Big Dig. I'll tell you more about it in a second, but first, this is where they filmed a bunch of it. In fact, this whole area is where they filmed a ton of it. And when they were shooting the film, Ryan Reynolds came out and waved to my doc. And me and him made eye contact, and I now consider him to be my best friend. He doesn't know it, but I don't have his phone number for my emergency contact, but I just put his Twitter. So yeah, this is Boston's financial district. And there used to be a big parking garage here to your left, but they put it underground. It's nice. There's a fountain there, but they didn't put the water on yet, which I'm fine with, because if you go to the Intercontinental Hotel or a bar called Biddy Early's, that's where it is. And if you don't like drinking your tea black, you can add some milk to it, like this giant hood milk. Okay, this is kind of cool. There's not actually a milk in there. It's just basically like Rivera's house. It's on North Street. There's the old North Church that's on Salem Street. And if you want to go left, you can go to Chinatown. It's like a 10-minute walk down that way. You can go straight up State Street, and then you're kind of parallel to Faneuil Hall and Quincy Market.
Una coppia che te la ruova deve cucire.
Sadly, it's probably a retirement project. So okay. I'll get to that, but now I have the thing that's very nice and inspire me to play one day. Okay, have not. I know your kids are golfers. Did you buy yourself a new pair of golf clubs? Like, what did you do?
I have some pizza, so put back home.
Kid-sized golf clubs?
I love
them. Oh, she has a kid.
Hey, c'è per cubio.
That's awesome, too. Evans, did you have any fun with your winnings, or did you get back to?
Mjesto gdje je bila bostonska čajanka.
Jel Nane ili Kamilca?
Od Nane?
Od Nane. Bez mlijekom, bez mlijeka.
E to je već ovaj biranje bilo za one britanske robovlasnike.
Ako nisu stavili mlijeka, duboko su uvrijedili Britanci.
Tako je. Joj, nek se to je onaj čaj njihov, nek se prosuo.
A što je najtoženije njihov?
No, indijski.
And I assure you, if any woman is qualified to lead the town meeting, I am she. You see, my father is the town's electman out in Watertown, as was his father before him. And in fact, they held town meetings in my home growing up.
Yes, good day to you all, as I have to say. Thank you for such a spirited introduction, Mrs. Stearns. Now, we are gathered here to discuss yet another crisis forced on us by Parliament, supposedly on behalf of our monarch, King George III. See, right now in our harbor lie three ships, the Eleanor, the Dartmouth, and the Rebeaver. Their holds are bursting with 340 chests of East India Company tea. Now, under the law, each of these vessels has only 20 days to offload this cargo and to pay the duties or taxes that are owed. Tomorrow is the 20th day for the ship Dartmouth, making this meeting all the more important, as this is your last chance to sway these events in our favor! As I expect earlier this day, it was requested that the Dartmouth no longer buy or sell any of these unjustly taxed goods. And many of the women here in town, our very own daughters of liberty, also joined with non-consumption agreements, further stating that none of these English goods would enter their patron's home. Well, don't you see, Boston? It has been by your united efforts, by your united resolves, you force these towns and duties to be repealed! All of them, that is, save one of colonies. It is full of fierce and independent, that of the Mohawk tribe. Now rally, patriots! Huzzah!
Huzzah! In harbor of teapot tonight.
Why, it's clear to me that there is nothing more in...
Well, before the Eleanor, my friends, and may I say welcome to your new life of crime. Huzzah!
Huzzah!
Now, before we begin, I do have a few questions to ask. If you are here to destroy the king's tea, say aye.
Aye.
If you are here to cast off this yoke of parliamentary tyranny, say aye.
Aye.
If you are here to be captured and arrested for treason, say aye.
Oh.
No one will be arrested for treason. Do you know why I do know the punishment for treason is?
Death.
Yes, death. By hanging. In the Boston Common, in front of everyone. Very embarrassing. Sophia, I would rather like to avoid that whole fall of you would as well.
Right.
So with these deadly consequences in mind, we must be very aware of where our enemies lie. There is, of course, the Navy, and there are three British warships in this very body of water. The Captain, the Active, and the Kingfisher. They're about 500 yards that way, but of course you can't see them because it's so dark and stormy on this moonless night. But rest assured, they have been told that they cannot fire upon us with their 100 combined cannons unless we attempt to sail off with the tea still on board. Now, my friends, we're not planning on taking this tea out of Boston Harbor, are we?
No,
we're putting the tea into Boston Harbor, so we needn't worry about them. There is the military, but they're miles away on Castle Island, and they cannot even... On to the matter at hand. We have 114 chests of tea to destroy here on the Eleanor alone.
One, the chai.
Two, three, over there! There they go, sinking irretrievably into Boston Harbor, never to be seen again, as long as you don't look at them. Now that's three down, 111 to go. Huzzah! Now I say it's time we storm below deck and survey the rest of the cargo. And of course, when I say storm below deck, I do mean please follow me in a single file line. Introduce the handrail, watch your step, and if you holler, watch your head. We have a saying here in Boston, which is safety first,
treason second.
Thank you, Mrs. Stern. And you be sure to only use this set of stairs. These are the downstairs, those are the upstairs. It's very bad luck to go down the upstairs. My father was a captain. We take sailor superstition much too seriously. What is your name, my friend? Mr. McIntosh, I'm going to have you stand next to that chest of tea. Make sure no one passes past that point. You're my boarding party captain. It's a very simple job. I'll tell you what it means in a moment.
Može, ide britanski čaj u more.
When you do hold that seat, make sure to keep both feet on the brown part of the deck. We only want tea in the harbor tonight, and none of you. Just so you know, that windlass does rotate, so
to some higher ground. Flip it around like this. Do it. Check out the banging sound. I'm gonna bring you up. You never want to come down. Yo. Action.
Hey.
What? Get it. Do it. Drop it. Hold. Groove on the one.
Everybody clap. Clap. Everybody clap your hands. Clap. Everybody clap your hands.
Evo ga, idu ljudi na buseve, tu se lagano puni. Evo još tu oni buseva oko cijelog parka. Ja idem da ostavim svoju ovu torbove stvari i lagano i motel s njom.
Evo trkači iz Bijelog vala, gdje čeka me Dim. Ona je isičala dobar maraton s obzirom na stazu u Bostonu i danas dosta toplo vrijeme. 3.28. Ja sam trčao 3.20. Daleko od nekih očekivanja. Mislim da sam pretjerao u treningu. A nešto slično što mi se već dešavalo. Ali tada svakako nije za rezultat. U svakom slučaju velika je stvar učestvovati na ovakvom maratonu. Evo je Dina koja se diže svoj broj, to jest svoju torbu koju je ostavila prije trke. Show your bib number. Čestitam.
Hvala. Kako ste?
Ti si dobro odradila. Malo atmosfere iz parka Boston Common.
Boston Common, Čaba.
A ranjenice su tu.
Ranjenice s Neretve se prostrli. Sa harde i kila ranjenice. Slomljeni srdaca.
Ranjenice pristigli sa Newton Berda. Četiri Newton Berda i zadnji Heartbreak Hill.
Kaže, welcome to the top of Heartbreak Hill. Kad još jedno brdašce iza njega, jesi vidio? O, rekao, više jebu ga, brdo.
Bilo je, bilo još tri brda poslije, onaj, na.
Bilo. Zoriko, vidjet će li spat ovo brdo. I pred kraj opet ono, pa onda onaj underpass ispod mosta.
Hotel pripremljeno za trkače, besplatan. Besplatno voće i voda i kafa. Jesu, jesu, počastili nas. Jest.
Evo
kako deru ovi američki šahtovi.